in the name of Allah. In this lecture, I will talk about how to choose the correct cross-section area for the neutral cable and the earthing cable. After choosing the correct cross-section area for the main phases R, S and T in square millimeter, we must know how to choose the correct cross-section area for the neutral cable and for the earthing cable. We must know that the electrical loads are three-phase loads or single-phase loads. For example, maybe we have a three-phase motor, which means that this motor needs the three phases R, S and T. Or maybe we have a single-phase motor. This means that this motor needs only one phase R or S or T with the neutral. So, for the three-phase load, this means that we have the three phases R, S and T only without the neutral. So, every phase of the three phases R, S and T in this load carries the same value of current. This means that this load is a balanced load. This means that there is no current will flow through the neutral. This means that the neutral current is zero. But for the three phase load plus the single phase load like a distribution board, this means that we have the three phases R, S and T plus the neutral. So every phase of the three phases R, S and T in this load maybe carries the same value of current. This means that this load may be a balanced load, which means that there is a small current will flow through the neutral. This means that the neutral current is very low. But for the single phase loads, this means that we have only one phase R or S or T plus the neutral. So every phase of the three phases R, S and T doesn't carry the same value of current, which means that this load is an unbalanced load, which means that there is a high current will flow through the neutral, which means that the neutral current is high. Finally, for the electronic loads, this means that these loads have current harmonics in their phases R, S and T like the third harmonics. So these loads are unbalanced loads. This means that there is a high current that will flow through the neutral cable according to the harmonics. So first we must know our loads to choose the correct cross-section area for the neutral cable and the earthing cable. For example, as we can see in front of us, three-phase cables or multi-core cables with three-phase conductors R, S and T and the neutral conductor and earthing conductor. As we can see on the left side, a multi-core cable with a cross-section area of 70 square millimeter for the three-phase conductors R, S and T and 35 square millimeter for the neutral conductor and the earthing conductor. Also, as you can see on the right side, a multi-core cable with a cross-section area of 70 square millimeter for the three-phase conductors R, S and T and the neutral conductor and 35 square millimeter for the earthing conductor. So my question is, how can we choose the correct cross-section area of this cable? Is it on the right side or on the left side? In the previous lectures, I told you how to choose the correct cross-section area for the main phases R, S and T by calculating the load current, thermal current, voltage drop and short circuit calculations. So, after choosing the correct cross-section area for the main phases, R, S, and T in square millimeter, the correct steps to choose the suitable cross-section area for the neutral cable and for the earthing cable R. As we can see in the table in front of us, the correct steps to choose the correct cross-section area of the neutral cable conductor R. First step, if the loots are electronic loots or any loots have more harmonics, so the cross-section area of the neutral cable is the same as the cross-section area of the phase cable. Second step, if the cross-section area of the phase cable is smaller than or equal to 35 square millimeter, so the cross-section area of the neutral cable is the same as the cross-section area of the phase cable. Third step, if the cross-section area of the phase cable is greater than 35 square millimeter, so the cross-section area of the neutral cable is half of the cross-section area of the phase cable. As we can see in the table in front of us, the correct steps to choose the correct cross-section area of the earthing cable conductor are: first step, if the cross-section area of the phase cable is smaller than or equals 16 square millimeter, so the cross-section area of the earthing cable is the same as the cross-section area of the phase cable. Second step, if the cross-section area of the phase cable equals 25 square millimeter or 35 square millimeter, so the cross-section area of the earthing cable equals 16 square millimeter. Third step, if the cross-section area of the phase cable is greater than 35 square millimeter, so the cross-section area of the earthing cable is half of the cross-section area of the phase cable. And thank you.